Good morning, welcome to our time of prayer together. Let's start by preparing our hearts. Grace, mercy and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you. Today is a day that the Lord has made, so let us rejoice and be glad in it. We've come together this morning in the name of Christ. To offer our praise and thanksgiving, to hear and receive God's holy word, and to pray for the needs of the world, so that by the power of the Holy Spirit we can give ourselves today to the service of God. Let's just take a moment to reflect on the day, and the fact that it is a gift from God, and that the night is over. So the night has passed, and the day lies open before us. So let us pray with one heart and one mind. As we rejoice in the gift of this new day, so may the light of your presence, O God, set our hearts on fire with love for you, now and forever. Amen. We're going to go back to Job, and we're going to read Job 3. So if you'd like to get your Bibles, we're going to read together Job's response to his friend's visit. After this, Job opened his mouth and cursed the day of his birth. And Job said, "Let the day perish on which I was born, and the night that said, a man is conceived. Let that day be darkness. May God above not seek it, nor light shine upon it. Let gloom and deep darkness claim it. Let clouds dwell upon it. Let the blackness of the day terrify it. That night, let thick darkness seize it. Let it not rejoice among the days of the year. Let it not come to the number of the month. Behold, let that night be barren. Let no joyful cry enter it. Let those who curse it curse the day, who are ready to rouse up Leviathan. Let the stars of this dawn be dark. Let the hope for light but have none, nor see the cyclades of the morning, the eyelids of the morning, because it did not shut the doors of my mother's womb, nor hide trouble from my eyes. Why did I not die at birth? Come out of the mother of the womb and expire. Why did the knees receive me, or why the breast that I should nurse? For then I would have lain down and been quiet. I would have slept and would have been at rest with kings and counselors of the earth who ruined for themselves, or with princes who had gold, who filled their houses with silver. Or why was I not in as hidden stillborn child, as infants who never see the light? There the wicked cease from troubling, and the weary are at rest. There the prisoners are at ease together. They hear not the voice of the taskmaster. The small and the great are there, and the slave is free from his master. Why is light given to him who is in misery, and life to the bitter in soul? Who long for death, but it comes not, and dig for it more than for hidden treasures, who rejoice exceedingly and are glad when they find the grave? Why is light given to a man whose way is hidden from God, and God has hedged him in? And my sighing comes instead of my bread, and my groanings are poured out like water. For the thing that I fear comes upon me, and what I dread befalls me. I am not at ease, for I am quiet. I have no rest, but trouble comes. We've seen Job suffer, and now we see him beat the ground in anger. Anger and the why question are perfectly appropriate in a moment of suffering. Why was I born? Why should I continue to live? Job is furious. We don't know how long Job has been sat on the ash heap outside the town. His friends have come, and they've reminded him of his spiritual wisdom and his wealth. And it's all gone. And his outraging is natural. But there's a verse tucked away in this that indicates what might be at the cause of Job's anger. It's right at the end of the passage, verse 25. For the thing that I fear comes upon me, and what I dread befalls me. Job's obviously lived all his life with this fear that all his wealth and all that he possesses will fall away. He has been captured, despite all his holiness, by living with anxiety and fear that he might lose the precious things he has. And so he shouts in the face of God. I just wanted to take away that there's nothing wrong with being angry and cross and hurt and screaming the why questions. We're going to see that Job's friends attempt to answer the Job. But at the moment, Job is just in a place of terror and despair. Now, that's not at the moment for us to answer why God has done this. That will come later. But now we just need to acknowledge that when we have friends who are in bad places, we need to let them rage. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Awake, O sleeper, and arise from the dead, and Christ shall give you light. You died, and your life is hid with Christ. Today, set your mind on things above, not on things that are of the earth. We're going to say the Lord's Prayer together as we begin our prayer today. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be thy name, your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Let's pray. Father, we pray for prayers of thanks for Sunday, for the chance to be together and to worship you. We look forward to the day when we will be able to worship together again in each other's presence. We pray for all the people that have heard the word preached online, that you would take it into their hearts, that they would be convicted by it. Pray for the leaders of our nation, Lord. The nation seems to be in disarray. The press out to attack and vilify the leadership panicking and trying its hardest to bring the nation back online. Pray for the numbers to continue to fall in the COVID crisis. We pray for doctors and nurses who continue to work in the front line. We pray for the schools, our schools, Redlands, Highgate and Cossington as they prepare to go back next week. We pray for our year 10s and year 12s as they prepare to go back to school. Father, we ask that you'd have mercy on our nation. It strikes us, Lord, that what Job said, his fear and anxiety at losing everything, is so true for our society, and this COVID crisis has brought it about. The reality of the fear we've had for a long time. And Lord, it's right that people should shout and be angry. But let's get the answer right, Lord, that it is to turn back to you, to live by your standards. And so, Father, take the day. Be with the Barber family as they prepare for a funeral on Wednesday. And just be in our day. The Lord bless us and preserve us from all evil and keep us in eternal life. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. Now let's say the grace together as the family of God. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen. Have a good day this bank holiday. I hope you do something interesting and exciting. Join us again tomorrow for the next set of Peace of Job, when Eliphaz decides to try and answer Job's question and gets it a little bit wrong. Have a good day. God bless.
Everlasting kindness, you lavished on me.